Yeah, it's your boy Fist in his house, bringing another great edition of a brand new matte black box. If you don't know, I've already did one video on it, and I did the Moab. People are all upset about it, talking about, you know, I did two losing camping games in the Moab. I don't really care. I don't even think you should care either. It's a video game. You know, I used to care. But I mean, there's no handbook on YouTube or anything that says that I should, you know, like, should play a certain way. I mean, it doesn't really matter. I mean, as long as you get it, you get it. I mean, nobody questions you. Well, I guess they do in real life. They question you how you make your money, but, you know, but if you're getting, if the money is in your hand, I mean, regardless of how you got it, that's on you. You know, I mean, I guess, you know, people look at it different ways. I mean, once you get to a certain status and you get enough money, nobody really cares how you got the money. That's what I learned when I went to Beverly Hills. And it was in California. I was like, man, people don't care, you know, if you got your money this way, that way, or the other way. As long as you got it, then it's like, you know, you break out of that certain type of mentality, you know, of whether or not, you know, it was on legit means. I mean, realistically speaking, I mean, I was looking at the Armin Hall family's house on a big-ass mountain mansion. I mean, the only reason why they got their money and the stuff they do is because they were there first and they came up with, you know, I mean, come on, all the people that used to work for them when they first came out, they weren't under a union or they had, like, slave labor. So, I mean, I look at it this way. It's the same thing about, like, getting Moabs and everything else. You know, you get a couple, but then once you start stacking them, you know, people are like, Did they do the same amount of Moabs? They know how hard it is to get Moabs, so it doesn't matter whether your team is losing. I don't really care. You know, I don't know. It's just, it's something that you have to experience. And I don't know, I'm just correlating it with real life situations and stuff like that. You know, if you never had $100,000 in your hand, then you don't know what problems come with it and like how you'll react to that money and everything else. And then it's a whole nother realm of people and things and everything. And the same thing goes with Moabs, you know, I mean, people might get mad at you getting Moabs, you know, and they don't like them, and but it's not the fault of the person who's getting the Moabs. I mean, they paid their money just like the next person, and then they get the Moabs. I mean, if the developers didn't want that in the game, then they shouldn't put it in specific game types to ruin, like, Ground War. You know, the only place you should be able to get a Moab is, like, hardcore team deathmatch, Ground War team deathmatch. Then you know, that should be the only place that you should be able to get them. Then, you know, people would probably, you know, feel a lot better about it, I guess. I don't really know. So, anyways, I'm on this new map, Black Box, with the MSR, sniping away. And I'm not a quick scoper, but, you know, if I'm going to snipe, this is how I'm going to use the sniper. I mean, this is how I think the sniper should be used. You know, obviously, you know, you got this building in front of you, and then you got this house on the hill, you got the plane, and then you got the construction building. The construction building, you know, there's topside, C, all the way down to A, I think it is, or I don't know how it goes, A, C, whatever's on the bottom hill, I think it's C, I'm not sure. But and I've seen a lot of people, they were talking about, you know, how bottom side, there's no disadvantage. I mean, there's a huge disadvantage. I don't care what anybody says. You come up that hill right there looking down that spot and anywhere around there and then that building across the way. If you put two, three guys in this building and two and three guys across from B, I mean, you literally, you could shut them down. They can't even get to B. I mean, they talk about, oh, yeah, you know, once you cap B, it's a lock. No, it's not a lock. You got to get to B first. And you're not going to come up the hill against two, you know, this building, if you lock this building down, it's really hard to come up that side of the bill. You know, I'm not going to say it's, like, completely unbalanced. I would say, like, the advantage is topside. How about that? You know, some people say advantage is bottom, but I don't think so. Because you can come down and grab A easy on him. Even it, because you can have one guy on top construction looking at the building. The whole building that's looking down on A's all glass. So if you got somebody looking on that building and they're like, they're going to cover them to go to A, that's it. They can't. I mean, unless they all sit in the corner in that broken ass, you know, crumbling building. I don't know, way in the corner, which, you know, I don't know. But this is just me, you know, like I said, I'm playing the MSR. I mean, every time I say something, like if I say, oh, hey, I'm going to do Moabs. And then if I get them, they're like, oh, you didn't win. You know, you didn't go for. I mean, I see a lot of people. They didn't go for. I mean, there's other commentators out there that never go for their tags. They make it a point to get a Moab in 2 minutes or less. But they don't go for shit. And it's all in objective-based games. Man, I mean, nobody's bitching about that. Who cares, you know? And the funny thing is that people only show, like, the part where they get the Moab anyway. Because, like, they're trying to hide the fact that, you know, there's some unwritten rule on YouTube. If you don't win the game, then you're a bad person. Which is ridiculous. Like I said, it goes back to the fact that if the developers didn't want the Moab in the game types, they would have left them out of like objective based game types. But they're not. They're in every game type. So it's on them. It's not on the player. Don't hate the player. Hate the developer. So this is how I use the MSR. And, you know, first thing I'm going to do is I want to take over this, like I said, this construction building. This is my first choice. And then I'd probably go for the building above the plane. That'd be my second choice. They're just really easy to defend with the sniper rifle with my slow-ass style of sniping. Now, if you're a ladder stall, true 360, achy breaky off the back and whatever, then yeah, you can go anywhere. I'm just not me, though. But I thought you guys would enjoy this gameplay because, you know, I like to snipe sometimes. I'm like I said, I'm not like a super sniper or nothing. I just like to snipe sometime. And so, I mean, I figured this was a good game comparative to all the people that were in this game, like as far as their rank wise, my score compared to the ranks using the MSR. I thought it was pretty good. And the way that I'm playing the sniper is how, you know, I think it's fair. You know, I mean, if some of you play the sniper against me like this, I think it's fair. I think that's how a sniper should be played. I mean, I think it's fair to the game itself, you know. Now, I mean, I'm not going to discount the fact that if I was like a badass with a sniper rifle and I could quick scope and do all that shit, then I'd probably be jocking that too. But, you know, I mean, I to be honest with you, if I was quick scoping and I was getting a lot of great ass scores and all that, I mean, You do like to like throw stuff in people's face in this game. You know, you do like to shit on people. So that's the fun part about it. So I don't want to discount that from nobody because that's, you know, I do that stuff with my own, with all the other weapons that I use and what my tactics. So if I could get away with the quick sniping, then I would do it. So in all essence, I mean, if I practice more and use sniping more, and I guess the more and more that I play this game and I'm getting away from the fact that, you know, I can't take my KDR to the bank and get a loan. You know, I'm not going to walk around with a shirt. This is Modern Warfare 3. Here's my KD and everybody's going to look up to me. More and more I get over that, you know, whole thing. Then, you know, and then maybe I'll, like, do more sniping or be more well-rounded. I'm getting there. So, you know, I'm getting there. I, like, the game before this, I was playing hardcore on this map with a sniper, which is real cool. Double clap! Woohoo! Look at me! Look at me! Look at me! Look at me! And I am using specialist, so I'm not going for any streaks, so who knows what would have happened with my streaks and everything if I would have went with streaks on this game. These are all kills with the specialist program. And, anyways, I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you on Friday. Until next time, it's your boy Fist. Peace! And I'm out.